Hello. Please can you give an update on where things stand currently with the council and INEOS, the shale gas energy company, regarding licensing agreements?
Mrs. Bottom, thank you very much for the question. Can you hear me better now? That can better. Let me sit down.
That's where you should be, there, so we can hear you.
I can stand over there, but then I'll move back to you, Mrs. Potter, so I'll happily turn around and talk to you. Thank you very much for the question.
I can hear you now.
Good. Unusually, today I'm going to read a written answer, because that's not using my style, as you well know from previous questions you've asked me over the years. INEOS was issued a number of petroleum exploration and development licences in Derbyshire by the Oil and Gas Authority at the end of 2015. Derbyshire County Council has no regulatory power or role in that process, which is undertaken at a national level. At present, Derbyshire County Council has received two planning-related applications from INEOS. These relate to a planning application for the exploration of a coal well at Bramley Moor Lane, Marsh Lane, Eddington, and a prior notification for the Part 17K of the Town and Country Planning Act, General Permitted Development Order 2015. With regard to the planning application, it is still at a very early stage. The proposal is for a drilling or exploration well 2.4 kilometres deep using a drilling rig that will be up to 60 metres in height. The application also makes provision for the creation of a new vehicular access on the site infrastructure, including offices, welfare cabins, security fencing and car parking. Drilling operations are anticipated to take approximately 10 weeks on a 24-hour basis. Once drilling operations have been completed, the application proposes retention of the well and association infrastructure for approximately a 5-year period, after which the site will be restored back to agriculture. That's the up-to-date state of play. Thank you.
So, supplementary, yeah. What is the view of the council on fracking for shale gas and on cleaner energy sources?
Well, Ms. Spotter, I'm sure you'll appreciate that every planning application this authority receives is dealt with in a appropriate fashion. Planning applications are quasi-judicial legislation, and it is inappropriate for this council to take a position on an application before it has been submitted. I am sure there are many councillors in this chamber who may have a view on the issue you just related to, but I would expect this authority to deal with every application on its own merits and deal with it in a totally unbiased fashion. Any councillor expressing a view on those issues prior to the decision and the discussion about a fracking application for this authority, in my view, will be excluded from taking part in the planning debate, because they will already compromise their position and compromise the position of the council. So I cannot possibly give you an opinion of what this council thinks on an application that will be submitted at a later date.
So I'll say to you, if that's your attitude, expect us.
Excuse me, Mr. Potter, you've had your supplementary question and you have your answer.
Expect us.
We have another question from Marie Crowley to Councillor Barry Lewis, candidate for Council Services. It is my, I'm told, Ms. Crowley is not yet registered. Thank you. council constitution concerning public questions, and please amend it so that it states that all questions submitted by members of the public to council meetings will be read out, and all responses to questions, whether the person is in attendance or not, will also be given publicly at the council meeting. What happens at present is that the constitution states that it is only the questions from the public who are actually in attendance at the meeting itself, and answers to non-attendees are replied to in an email. If all answers could be given publicly, this would be so much better for openness and transparency, and ensure that all questions from members of the public and all the answers from both members of the public who attend and those who cannot attend are in the public minutes as well.
Thank you, Chairman. My thank you, Mr. Crowley, for the question. I appreciate the sentiment about openness and transparency, and I'm sure that Ms. Crowley will agree that the facility for members of the public to ask questions at council meetings serves a very useful purpose. The Constitution, in fact, provides discretion to the Chairman about whether or not questions are read out in the absence of the question, and about whether or not answers are provided in public. I'm sure that the Chairman will bear the question in mind in the future, and that we can rely on her to exercise her discretion in a positive fashion. Thank you, Chairman.
Thank you, Councillor Lewis. On this occasion, this discretion will be given, so I decided that there will be a written response to that question. Third question, a question from Mr. Shippen, David Shippen, to Councillor Spencer, Cabinet Member for Transport and Infrastructure. Mr. Shippen has indicated he will not be attending, and I'm afraid he is not here. Will the new Conservative-led County Council please give their views on how they see HS2 in Derbyshire, and also say whether they will be joining the majority of members of their party in recognising that HS2 is, in fact, the lowest priority and the most hated policy highlighted by the recent poll of Tory Party members.
I have issued a press release with regard to a question tabled in a very simple fashion yesterday. HS2 is a government project, and the decision about the future of schemes are matters for government and not for Derbyshire County Council. We believe the best deal for Derbyshire will be achieved by working with government to maximise the economic benefits and minimise the adverse impacts on the scheme that affect Derbyshire residents. Thank you.